Could the Browns win a Super Bowl with Baker Mayfield? I suppose it's possible. I don't think it's a great bet, though. He'd have to do like what Eli Manning did, like be solid and steady, and then when you need him most, have an all-time clutch performance. Are you banking on that? Is that something you should bank on as a GM, Mike D?
No, no, and no. You have to go get somebody that you could go win a championship with. And if I'm Andrew Berry and Kevin Stefanski, when I flew back from Foxborough, Massachusetts to Berea, Ohio, the sober reality is Baker Mayfield's just not good enough. And when you look at his career, he's thrown 33 more interceptions when it's straight drop back compared to play action. He needs a good running game. And without Chubb and Kareem Hunt, he was exposed yesterday. I would do everything I would have to do to go get Aaron Rodgers, Russell Wilson, or Deshaun Watson. And that's despite exercising the fifth-year option, because in the AFC, guys, he's just not good enough.
Well, I mean, I don't know if I agree with that, but if you pay him at the top of the market, then you don't have guys like Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt to help him, right? And Swaggy does not seem to me to be the kind of guy who can, obviously, like do an Aaron Rodgers and elevate everyone around him. What do you think Baker's prospects are as the long-term solution in Cleveland?
It's all about the money. And look, this is a subtraction. And I'm in agreement with Mike T. Listen, man, Baker Mayfield has to play within structure. He needs to be insulated in order to be a good quarterback. That's the bottom line. I know everybody get emotional about Baker Mayfield, and you know, he's all, you got his crew that love him and they fight to the tooth and nail for him, and then you got people that actually tell the truth. Well, Mike T and I are two people that actually tells the truth about Baker Mayfield. Listen, really feasible for you to go in and lose a game against the New England Patriots minus Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt. Not feasible to lose it 45-7, okay? And yes, I'm going to lay a lot of this at the altar of this defense. Obviously, they didn't want to show up and play in that same regard. But why do we look at all of the other good quarterbacks and hold them responsible for their team's success or demise? And then when it comes to Baker Mayfield, we talk about all of the other things around him. He was the first overall pick in the NFL. He will be critiqued harder than most quarterbacks in the NFL. That is the reality. And you know why you take quarterbacks number one overall? It's because they're supposed to make you better when you don't have a chance or when you lose, guys. He doesn't do that. That's the reality. Now, we can be emotional about it, but the reality of what we've seen is that Baker Mayfield is not going to lift the Cleveland Browns if it's not the perfect scenario.
Max, I totally agree with Swaggoo. Another way to say it, the inverse of it, was Baker Mayfield went to the stadium with an opportunity to show greatness, to say, you know what, put the whole team on my back, no Chubb, no Hunt, no problem. And he came up short in the biggest opportunity of his career, especially with OBJ moving on.
But Mike T, to your point, it's not even about that, right? Like, I understand what you're saying and I agree with you. Be better than you were, though. Like, be better than you were, even in a loss. Even if you lose the game to the New England Patriots, be better than that, because that is what people are banking on. The city of Cleveland is banking on it. Your teammates are banking on it. The coaching staff is banking on it. Look, Kevin Stefanski got whooped, all right? And we all know that Bill Belichick does that to a lot of coaches. Tom Brady struggled against Bill Belichick is the argument that people will throw out there. You know what he did, though? He still made plays. Dak Prescott had a good day. And the only reason I mention those guys' names is because those guys are considered guys that lift their team when things are not in perfect synergy with each other.
Keep in mind, Aaron Rodgers might be available after this season. Russell Wilson might be available after this season. Deshaun Watson, we'll see what happens off the field of play, could be available. Difference-making quarterbacks who could look at the Cleveland Browns, not a sexy destination usually, but could look at all the other pieces they have and think, as a pure football move, I could go there to win a Super Bowl.
And Max, this is also about who you have to beat.
That's right.
Who are you taking Baker Mayfield over the guys that we assume will be in the playoffs and going for a Super Bowl? That has this in it too, as well.
They have a lot of, by the way, forget about Patrick Mahomes and Lamar Jackson. You got Joe Burrow and Justin Herbert coming up in the AFC. It is gangster in the AFC at the quarterback position. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.